dragging our name through the mud, and I will not accept it.
I fucking had enough of both of you.
There's something fucking gone badly wrong.
Kevin, we don't want to take any risks, so box now for retirement.
Race over for Kevin Magnussen after contact with his teammate.
I got pushed out by my teammate. Was it on purpose or not? I don't know. But as long as he's front of me, he's happy. He doesn't give a shit about anything else. I need to calm down because I'm gonna do something stupid.
Can you go and get them?
Yes.
Please.
Sure.
Then I can fucking go home.
Yeah.
Roman, Günther just wants to speak upstairs.
I fucking had enough of both of you. You let the fucking team down, me down, which I protected you all the time. I have not more to fucking say to you guys. And if you don't like it, I don't need you here. Do not come back, please. What was that?
Kevin just fucking smashed the door. That's not acceptable.
Fucking hell.
Good morning. I do not often speak publicly. However, I'm extremely angry at any suggestion that we have cheated. Beyond the clear fact that Racing Point complied with the technical regulations, I am appalled by the way Renault, McLaren, Ferrari, and Williams have taken this opportunity to appeal, and in doing so, attempted to distract from our performances. These accusations are completely unacceptable and not true. They are dragging our name through the mud, and I will not stand by nor accept this. In closing, we did absolutely nothing wrong. We stayed within the rules, and we will demonstrate and prove that through the appeal process. Thank you for your time.
We have got a breaking news story. Christian Horner is dumping Renault next season.
Renault will stop supplying Red Bull from 2019. That's millions of dollars Renault will no longer be receiving next year. A blow to the Renault brand as one less team has a Renault engine next year. I'm in a bit of disbelief, to be honest. He lost faith.
You know, we've decided to take a different path for next year. We've been following the progress of Honda's development very closely. And the decision we've made is that Honda is absolutely the right route for the Red Bull. We're all selfish in this business. Renault's priorities obviously are their own team.
Yes, there was a substantial revenue associated to that supply, but there were also a substantial cost associated. And clearly, marginal in comparison to the overall budget of our organization as we speak.
Renault can afford pretty much anything. Renault is the largest car maker in Formula One, full stop. He bought into the project and made this decision.
Thank you.
Bad race for us, nothing more to say.
Really?
Yeah, nothing. I don't want to comment on it. It's enough.
Fucking hell, yeah. Continued like this, he's fucking banging our head against the wall. There's no point. I mean, it hurts too much. We're not going anywhere. And the car was a fucking rocket before. Is there something gone wrong? There's something fucking gone badly wrong.
It's very difficult to be very consistent.
Yeah.
If you're on your own, it's okay.
That's what I mean.
As soon as you're behind another car...
I don't want that one anymore.
Get a minute.
I always have a minute.
I show you. This is the official speeds.
I don't get it.
The car was not a piece of shit. So why did we develop a car which fucking goes slower? Find out the problem and make progress out of it instead of this is better. It isn't this is better. It fucking isn't.
Yeah. I want to see the progress. Yes. I mean, otherwise, I mean, like, I make changes, you know?
Whatever happens, I'm responsible to the owner of our team, Gene Haas. Let's hope he doesn't get frustrated too much.
We need to sort this out. We really, really need to sort this out.
In
my previous years, I had one target, and that was either put it on pole or win the race. I'm driving around in 19th position, week in, week out, and I don't want to be there.
I'm sure he's frustrated by some things that we haven't been able to action fast enough. I wish for both of them that we'd given them a better car this year.
It's just getting a joke at the moment. I've never been so inconsistent in my life. You look at the lap charts and you think I'm a bloody rookie or whatever. I felt like I was driving very similar lap after lap, and it was like a yo-yo. I felt like an idiot. We need to seriously pull our fingers out.
Okay, all right, well, we'll see what we can do about that.
So, this is the helmet that I will race in this year's Italian Grand Prix. And the best feature about this helmet for this weekend is that I will be able to take my mask off as soon as I'm wearing the helmet.
We cannot be too funny considering the performance after Belgium.
Says who?
No, we. Because
I think you should be funny if you look at our performance. So is that the credo for this weekend? Don't laugh.
No
jokes.
Umore alto.
Okay, so Charles, when will you launch your coating collection?
Oh, well, at the end, for now, it's on standby. It's something I really wanted to do, and it's something that I think I will keep in mind for the future.
What's the collection?
It was like full clothing, like full collection.
It's not allowed. That's why it's not happening. Because we have a partner, so he was told off. I'm not supposed to say that, but I'm leaving the end of the year, so I can say what I want, you know?